where the business has not worked. I've always worked in a very gentle way, very hand to mouth. So that has meant that my business has had a lot of freedom because we've not had shareholders who are looking for expansion all the time. So we've been able to be very spontaneous. And fashion, you need to be spontaneous. In design, you need to be spontaneous. So when I was building my business, I did it very much on my terms. And one of the key points about Paul Smith, especially in the 80s and the early 90s, was the learning to say no to opportunities that would have given you money, but would have sent you down the wrong path in terms of image or in terms of character. So trying to have the strength to say no is sometimes difficult when you need the money, but I can tell you it really works in the future. You talk about spontaneity, and if you look at the world of technology now, everyone is in a race to produce something that's better, that's more sophisticated, that's bigger, smaller, more colourful, more monochromatic than the bigger the last time. But how do you manage people's expectations when you're designing something now that isn't going to be seen or isn't going to be sold for sort of 6 or 9 months? Well, we're working on winter 2011 right now. We just had our fashion show for 2011 spring. Now I'm working on winter already. So you're always working a year ahead. And what I can say is the only way you sort of seem to know how to do it is because you love your job. And you sort of know what's going on. You know, like with Jonathan and Apple, you just feel it. You know what's going on. So you just flow with the river and you flow with the way you're feeling about things. And I think with me, as I said earlier, it's really about balance. It's not just about clothes, it's about how the shops look, about doing this right now. So it's a cocktail of doing lots of things. How would you define the Paul Smith DNA? Well, hopefully, clothes are just easy to wear, but they do have a character. A lot of designers design clothes which are quite attention-seeking. So you walk in a room and they've got an obvious logo on them, or they've got something very bright that makes people turn. But what I try and do is have clothes for people that are individual and that they can walk in a room, feel confident, but they know there's a little secret somewhere. So the DNA is really clothes for people that are comfortable with themselves. And my clothes, because they don't have distinctive logos, you can put your own character, so you can still be Billy Jones. You're not suddenly a Prada man or a Louis Vuitton man. You are who you are. So that's what I think is really important in today's world, to try and have your own individuality. Before we put questions out to the floor, are you going to design covers for the iPad? Well, we're working on it. iPad cover at the moment, but there's some pretty good ones out there, you see. And because they go like that, and they stand up. So I did one with the zip at the top, and I thought, that's ridiculous, you won't stand up. So back to the drawing board. There will be one soon.
Okay.
We have about 10 or 15 minutes for questions, so if anyone has a question, please put their hand up. And if you have some people with